Dear students, in this session we will learn about general characters of Ajnata. Now what are Ajnatans? I hope you remember this term. Jnata means jaws. Ajnata means the vertebrates without jaws. So they are jawless vertebrates, right? Now when you look at these pictures on the slide, can you make out in B, can you make out the circular mouth? So they have mouth like this. And around that you will have teeth, right? And at the center you can see the presence of tongue, and this tongue is also a presence of teeth like structures which helps in boring the tissues. Because now if you observe the figure A here, these petromyzon or lampreys, they live parasitic life, so they attach to the body of these big fishes, and when they attach with the help of their suctorial mouth, they penetrate this tongue with hooks to scrape off the tissues and they feed on that. Okay, so here you can see they don't have jaws but they have teeth. Fine. And C and D, they are the images of a myxin or the hagfishes. So they also have rounded mouth surrounded by five to six tentacles around the mouth, right? So these two are they belong to the class cyclostomata. Cyclo means circular, stomata cyclostomata meaning circular mouthed organisms. Okay, so I'm Dr. Lata, assistant professor in Zoology, Maharani Science College for Women, Bengaluru. In this session, we will learn about the general characters of these Ajnatans. So, let's start. So, what are Ajnatans? Ajnata means having no jaws. So, it includes all jawless fishes. They are cold-blooded and they have cartilaginous skeleton. Like sharks or the rays. Here if you look at this picture, it's a picture of an hagfish, and observe its mouth, it is round and circular, hence they fall under cyclostomata. So these Ajnatans are predicted to be the first vertebrates, and the oldest known fossils to these lancets are the tunicates. They existed some 550 million years ago. So the examples of these living examples of these Ajnatans are the lampreys and hagfishes. So they belong to the phylum Chordata, subphylum Vertebrata, and division Ajnata because they are jawless, and they come under class cyclostomes or cyclostomata. Now let us, now these Ajnatans, actually they are classified into two classes. One is ostracodermy and cyclostomata. Now these cyclostomata includes petromyzoan and myxin, the lampreys and the hagfishes. They are the living forms, whereas the other class, the ostracodermy, they are the extinct forms or the fossil forms. Now when we say ostracodermy, ostra, O-S-T-R-A, ostra means thick scale or bony kind of structures, dermy means skin. So the skin of these ostracoderms were armored, means the scales were very thick and huge. So the body was covered by thick scaly like appearance. Armored means either they would have modified into spines or still further hardened thick structures. Okay, so these ostracoderms, they do not exist anymore. They are the extinct forms. But they had this bony kind of skin, and hence the name ostracodermy. but they also exhibited a fish-like body, usually flattened dorsoventrally. They had a huge head and a gill region. They had muscular trunk and some sort of tail fin. They didn't show exact presence of a tail, but they had some sort of tail fin. There were no jaws. They didn't have any pectoral or pelvic fins, and they possessed only median fins in them. And the body was very bony and heavily armored. Armored, A-R-M-O-U-R-N-E-T. Armored means like they had long, thick spiny like projections on their body. And head was enclosed in a solid shield made of bony dermal plates. And then rest of the body showed the presence of small scales. Because of flattened body and feeble fins, since fins were not well developed, they were bottom dwellers and filter feeders. And their internal anatomy is not much known. And their body covering has these thick scales, and people think that these scales were the ones which gave them protection against the predators of those times. Okay, so when these ostracodermies were living, they had these gained scorpion-like arthropods, which were also predominant at those Cambrian era, Cambrian and Silurian periods. So in order to get protected from these predators, these ostracodermies would have developed such kind of armored skin. Okay, thick bony skin. But once these predators also descended, then slowly even these ostracodermies, they lost these thick bony skin, and in turn they gave rise to these living Agnathans. This is one version of zoologists. And when you look at these cyclostomes, the pictures that you are seeing here, they look little wormy form. They look like worms, right? A big thick worm. So they look like a wormy form of craniates with smooth scaleless skin. If you observe the skin, you don't find any scales on them. And they have suctorial mouth, but they don't have jaws. And it is this suctorial mouth which helped them to attach to the larger fishes, and they live as parasite. Lamprey is a parasite. Hagfish, like, it does not live like a parasite. It is a bottom dwelling form. With the help of a suctorial mouth, it gets attached to the substratum or to the huge rocks. They are mostly marine, and very rarely a few freshwater fishes are also found. And if you observe, the body gets divided only into head and the trunk. And as you saw in the very first introductory slide, their mouth was round with a piston-like tongue, and this which are fedded with horny teeth, and these teeth helps in scraping off the host tissue, which in turn helps them in feeding. And they breathe by around 6 to 14 pairs of gills. They have this two-chambered heart, and they show around 8 to 10 pairs of cranial nerves, and they possess distinct notochord, and sexes are separate, and fertilization here is also external. And development, if you see in case of lamprey, it is indirect because they give rise to amosite larva, which in turn metamorphose into an adult, whereas in case of hagfishes, it is direct development. So these are few differences that you find between ostracodermy and cyclostomata. Now all put together, we will just learn what are the general characters of Agnathans as such. And now when we say these characters, that is, these characters are common to both ostracodermies and cyclostomes. Since ostracodermies are extinct, our main focus is only on the cyclostomata, cyclostomes, which include hagfishes and lampreys. So the very first character that comes to our mind is they are Egnathan, so the jaws are absent, and they have thin, slender, elongated body. They show the presence of suctoral mouth. They lack exoskeleton, whereas endoskeleton is in the form of it is cartilaginous. Paired fins are generally absent, but the embryonic notochord persists even in the adult. Then body is divided into head and trunk. It bears a pair of eyes, and between these eyes, towards the anterior most region, you find a nasal aperture. Notochord is persistent even in the adult. The nerve cord is fibrous. The vertebral column is represented by small imperfect neural arches over the notochord. It has got single nostril, which we said like it is present in the form of a nasal aperture. There are around 7 to 14 pairs of gills. 7 or more, generally it ranges from 7 to 14 pairs of gills. The internal ear is seen with one or two semicircular canals. And the branchial arches that support the gill pouches, they lie very close to the body surface. They do not show presence of any paired appendages. They are absent. Pineal eye is present. Then if you look at the internal structures, like the digestive system, it lacks stomach. Because lampreys, they are parasitic in form, so they did not have to have a stomach in them. Then heart is two-chambered, venous heart without a conus arteriosus in it. Then a lateral line system is present, which acts as a sense organ. They show about 8 or 10 pairs of cranial nerves that are present. Kidneys are paired, elongated and primitive without a renal portal system. Genital ducts are absent, and sexes are separate. Fertilization is external, and there are no larval stages seen in hagfishes, so here development is direct. Whereas long larval periods of around 3 to 7 years are observed with amosite larvae in lampreys, which exhibit indirect development. So these are some of the characters of Egnathans, and all this content are taken from these reference textbooks and these two sites. So for any more information, you can log on to this or refer these books and you can read more. So thank you for listening. I hope you have understood the general characters of Egnathans and how these cyclostomes are differ from ostracoderms. Thank you for listening.